This is Praxis, and I'm here on site with the crew that's putting in the rest of the perimeter drain. They're just working around this back area here. I got here a little bit earlier before them this morning, and I took a stick and poked through all the pass-throughs out through the foam so we'd know the heights of them, where they are on the outside of the foundation in terms of the water line, so we wouldn't be necessarily filling in that area where the water line has to come in anyway. And also, I drew a fill line all along the back wall so that they would have a sense of where it would be good to fill up to, because I still have to do another course of foam over the back wall, and I'm hoping that they can kind of put in the perimeter drain, fill it in, and then after that, I can stand right on top of it and I can put up the last layer of foam and go from there. We also talked about the utility lines coming in. There's the electric utility line through this trench that's already been made, and the water line has to come back through this area here, and you can see there's a pretty large tree that's felled right there. We're gonna have to cut through there and figure out how the water line's gonna come up. The water line needs to be like 4 or 5 feet under the ground. That's to prevent it from freezing in the winter. We gotta kind of figure out where that's gonna be, because there's a lot of rock under the soil. Sometimes you dig down, you hit rock, so we gotta figure that out. But once it gets up into this area, we're gonna be bringing in so much fill to bring up the area. Honestly, if the water line was just laid right on the surface now, it would be getting filled in later. I had some big developments over the past 24 hours with the root cellar / fallout shelter. I think we are going to do it. I got a pretty decent price from the concrete people, and we're going to be putting it over where this pile of dirt is, just to the left of the foundation over here. It's going to cost about $9,000 for all the materials and labor to put it in, but we're going to be saving about $2,000 worth of fill that I was going to have to buy to bring in anyway. So that brings the cost down to about $7,000, which is still a lot of money, although I suppose if you knew that there was a nuclear attack imminent, it would seem like money well spent. But, I also like to just, have things feel like they have, plenty of use otherwise. But $7,000, remaining on the cost of the thing, and it's also going to be, it's going to be about 8 feet by 20 feet long, so there'll be a lot of storage space in there. So I'm going to get a lot of storage space. It'll be kind of like an underground shed that I can use. So that kind of comes off the cost of it. I won't have to build another shed. I know, like, the last shed that I built was about $4,000. It was an above ground one. So I save about $4,000 there, because I can use it as a shed immediately. It'll just be made for me. I won't have to build it or anything. So, that brings the cost down to about $3,000 out of pocket. So it's like $3,000 out of pocket. I don't have to build a shed. And I get a, root cellar / fallout shelter out of it. So for $3,000, it seems like it's a pretty good deal. So we're going to be doing that. Today, these guys are finishing up the perimeter drain, and I'm gone for a couple days, but then when I come back, my next thing is to finish up that last course of foam on the back of the foundation there. So that's it. Things are moving again. Things are positive. I'm pleased with how things are coming out, but there's still a lot of work left to go. That's it. Thanks for watching.